Space Engineers. This is Captain Rick Havoc with the Terran Republic Navy, and I hope you are all having a wonderful day. I am coming to you today with the second part of the combat review or review and combat evaluation of the TRSS Nevada. And today is when we do the combat evaluation portion of the review. Before we get started, I want to explain to you basically why I am trying to get this channel started. And that is because when I started playing Space Engineers and started looking at ship reviews on YouTube, I noticed that I was actually being told little or nothing about the actual capabilities of the ships being reviewed. There were two or three people who would basically fly around the outside and the inside of a ship, going on about its aesthetic features and whether they thought it was a good-looking ship or not. And some of them would then crash the ship into the planet, and one of them would even throw the ship down the mountainside. None of these things really tell the viewer what a ship can do when facing a ship. And there's another reviewer on YouTube that is just a little too over-concerned with PCU economy and how this feature is a waste of PCU and that feature is a waste of PCU. Again, telling me little or nothing about the capabilities of the ship. At least this reviewer tries more to give the viewer an idea what you can do with a ship and what a ship can do. But there's only one real way to find out what a ship can do against an enemy ship, and that's to actually put it up against an enemy ship. So out here in front of us we have, bring up the right toolbar and get the camera. And I can show you, we have an AI adversary ship. It's the ship that's in the workshop as the Carnifex battleship. And I'll be doing a review on it soon, and it will not be a flattering review. But in any case, this is the only really useful thing I've found to do with the ship, is to stick an AI core in it and use it for an adversary ship. And we're going to test this ship against that one. And we also have, at almost 15 kilometers, a drone spawning pirate station. So you're going to see a test of this ship's combat capabilities like no other reviewer has ever shown you. So please bear with me. Let's see. Alright, now the other thing I need to do before we get started is mention something I forgot to mention in the first part of this review, which is these modules on the top and sides of the ship. And what they're for. What they are is heat sinks, and they are for the cloaking device. It's also known as a stealth drive, but since it provides no propulsion, I prefer to call it a cloaking device. And this is not really the time or place to be demonstrating it, so you won't be seeing the cloaking device today. What you will be seeing is me closing with the enemy ship. Again. And the mission parameters here are basically to deprive this adversary of his point defenses, and so we can have a clear shot at shooting decoys and nuclear missile at him, taking him out. All the while we'll be getting drones coming at us from the pirate station. So this should be a pretty good test of ship's capabilities. About 3 kilometers. Take out his point defense. Maybe just a little under. Prometheus beam, focused beam lances are excellent at taking out point defense installations. that missile turret is no more. A nuke at him and some decoys. Rivaling the sun. And that, my friends, is what fireball looks like from three thermonuclear warheads. Must have got these last shots off just before the nukes arrived. Nuke, I should say. And that is the end of the Pirate Battleship Complex. Look for the review in the upcoming. And now we have our drone spawning station, and we need to set ourselves up with a missile to deal with that thing too. So close our missile doors. Build and repair. we need to put a different blueprint in the projector. Because right now, what is projecting is a decoy missile. And we don't want to hit that station with a decoy missile. We want to hit him with the real thing. But I don't think we want to. We don't need three warheads to deal with us with that little station. One warhead will be enough. Let's see. Yes, nuclear. I might not have gone too far. Yeah, there it is. That's the one we want. One warhead, missile two, copy to clipboard. And that's the best. And just like that, the welder's welded up. Alright. So now we can turn the projector back off and turn build and repair back on. But if I don't turn build and repair off, it will try to build the missile instead of letting the welders do the job they're supposed to do. And we need to fuel the missile, which is basically just we get the connector, and lock it on, and the hydrogen tank just fills automatically. Alright. Let's close the station. I'm trying to keep the time from running over long, but if I do, I hope you'll just bear with me. Not doing too bad so far. Probably will run over 30 minutes. Because does give the viewer, an idea of how tough the ship actually is. I am going to crash the ship into the planet as part of the test. So of course I have the speed mod activated. Another mod activated that other reviewers don't use. It's a mod that goes with the nuclear weapons and nuclear explosions. And the mod is called Kinetic Devastation. So when my ship hits the planet, the result will definitely be much more realistic. There will be more drawings before we reach firing range. And if I do say so myself, I equipped this ship and drones and fighters pretty well. take out his point defense. With this time with aimed artillery fire. That should be close enough. Threefer? We got a threefer. We got all three of those installations with one shot. That should pretty well take care of his point defense. Let's see. Yep, I don't see any more point defense. So, missile door. And here goes the missile. And there goes the pirate station. That's only one thermonuclear warhead. It's still a pretty impressive fireball. And definitely does the station in just fine. So, we need to make sure we have dealt with all the drones. Salvage drone, okay, we got drones still. Gunboat, yep. Yep, he's coming our way too. So I'll just sit here and wait for him. He's almost in range. The salvage drone. Let them come to us. Okay, let's see. We need to close our missile doors. Rust freighter. Thank you. take to do this. Can't leave any drones behind us. I don't really want to. Don't really want to leave any of these drones up here. Might cause other problems. Thank you. Alrighty then. Off. Headed on down. Sorry about the length of time, folks. I'm about to show you all this. Quite a capable ship, if I do say so myself. And we're about to see why I chose this blueprint, which started as an unfinished battleship blueprint by Matt Spaceman, over any of the other unfinished blueprints I have found in the workshop. There are a number of ships that don't have connection systems connecting all the weapons, don't have other things that make a ship complete. This ship did not have a connector system. It had a few connectors up in the front engineering bay, and that's it. A few conveyor tubes connecting two or three things up in the front, and that's all. The Matt Spaceman didn't even put conveyor tubes between the hydrogen tanks on each side, from the front tank to the rear tank on each side. The conveyor tubes in there. But what he did design was a very tough call. Be up over 800 by the time you get. moonbeam, an earth-shattering boom. Realizing I should have spectator mode enabled, but I don't. Well, when I crash a ship that I have to get out of before it hits, you'll see the first ship. But I'm gonna ride this ship right to the ground. Too close to the center of it all. That's okay. And I told you the speed would go up once we got into the gravity. Most ships are starting to burn up at this point, at this speed. Well, actually, not quite in the atmosphere. I haven't quite hit atmosphere yet. Any wind, not really. But I'd have to get the speed up over 1,000 meters a second. Real close to that mesa. Let's hope we'll get it. Should clear it. Hit it. foot of the mesa. Not under its own power. Do kind of wonder if I brought my tug down here, if it would actually pick this shit up, ship up or not. Here, but let me take this opportunity to remind you that if you are enjoying this content and want to see more of it, please remember to go down below and hit those buttons that will assure that you will see more of this content. The like and the subscribe and the notification bell, and please tell your space engineer friends about this channel and help me grow it. So, what's left? We got no bay door on the starboard missile bay anymore. It's like we might have lost some welders too. Yeah, we lost some welders. And our, we got pieces falling out still. I'm always interested to find out if the cloaking device survived. Ah, it did. There's the cloaking device right there. So we still got our cloaking device. At least one of our large cargo containers is still there. There's definitely some salvage here. That's all there is. That's all it is salvage here. I mean, even if I had to build a repair system on, it's too much for those. But still, this is one tough ship. Let me know in the comments below what you think of my tough ship.